ברוכים הבאים to כל אהבת ישראל here in Chabad in San Diego בעזרת השם. We're continuing with our next class of the Kollel, מסילת ישרים מהרמח"ל. We are doing our next class בעזרת השם is the path of the righteous, as we said, מסילת ישרים. And it's about the Ramchal, זיכרונו לברכה. As we mentioned before, the Ramchal was born in Padova in Italy, נולד באיטליה ב-1707 בעיר פדובה, and he was one of the most righteous tzaddikim that was born, that HaKadosh Baruch Hu sent him an angel, Raziel, to teach him when he was 11 years old. And before we start, we're going to do Refuah Shelema to Flori Bat Rachel, Anat Bat Zizel, Chaim Ben Remond, Yaakov Ben Genia, Yaniv Meir Ben Chana Anet, Mordechai Ben Esther, Rachel Yifrach, Einav Bat Zara, Binyamin Ben Natan, ויולטה בדורה, נחמן בן רות, ובעזרת השם אודליה בת שרה. אין נרפן עליהם, אין נרפן עליהם, יחד עם כל חולי עמך ישראל. מלכה בת שרה, רפואה שלמה תו מלכה בת שרה בעזרת השם. Thank you so much. All right, so as we mentioned, בעזרת השם, the Ramchal, by the way, in the book Shara Gilgulim, as we mentioned, the Arizal said that the Ramchal is reincarnation of the first 40 years of Rabbi Akiva. As we know, Rabbi Akiva, 40 shana ya bur ve'am ha'aretz. He was not very learned 40 years. The Ramchal came and fixed this 40 years, and is buried next to Rabbi Akiva. The Ramchal kavur בטבריה ליד רבי עקיבא, and it's four amot, it's four, you know, 2 meters from every amah is the 10 years from the burial of Rabbi Akiva. Okay. So we mentioned that the Ramchal, as we know, he wrote, some say about 200 books, but we only have very few that we merited to have. And as we mentioned, one of them is Mesilat Yesharim. And this Mesilat Yesharim has 26 chapters against Hashem, right? Yud Hei Vav Hei. And the opening of chapter 1 is really the first word also say Yesod HaChasidut VeShoresh HaAvodah, the acronym of God, Yud Hei Vav Hei. The essence of a person is to become a Hasid in their life and know the roots of Avodat Hashem. Nachon? So we did yesterday the first chapter, we talked about the essence of a person, ma ben adam chayav la'asod, what is a person has to do in order to really get close to Hashem. And Shlomo HaMelech, as we mentioned, said, adam la'amal yulad, what's a person is born to work, right? La'amal is an acronym, lilmod al menat lelamed. We are here to learn in order to teach. When we learn Hashem, work, you know, the mitzvot, the mishpatim, the chukot, everything that the sages gave us, we have ability to prepare ourselves for the world to come. As the Ramchal says, this is really the essence of what you are here. You are just in the mashanikra mizdaron, you are in the traklin, you are in, so to speak, the hallway to heaven. This is just a world mundane for us to come to fix everything. And the Ramchal continues and says, "Klalo shel davar, ha'adam lo nivra ba'avur matzavo ba'olam hazeh, ela ba'avur matzavo ba'olam haba." It says that a person was created in this world in order to be ready for the world to come. Nothing in his condition here, unless he is close to Hashem, is really reflecting what's going to be next. In essence, he says that man was not created for a situation in this world, but in the situation rather for the future situation in the world to come. So it says, yes?
Okay, I've heard this a few times more than about there seems to be some sort of dichotomy here, because one day here is greater than all the time in the world to come as well.
No, it's a 1 minute there is greater than all the pleasure of the world here, of all the people.
The converse also, yes? That
no.
Being here also has extraordinary merit, even in comparison
well,
to
here you can make you can make what we call Gan Eden Alei Adamot. You can make your life to be like heaven on earth, right? But really, a minute in heaven is worth than all the pleasure in the world of all the people of all creation combined, right? Forgive us, Harley Davidson did not convert yet, so we're still waiting. Be'ezat Hashem. It says, Hu ha'emtza'i le'matzavo ba'olam haba she'hu tachlito. It says, this is the tool. Hashem give you this life as a tool for the world to come. Right? The word emtza'i means the middle. Right? Emtza. But also, emtza'i, if you look, is really come from the word Matzah, it's really Hashem give you advice. La'atzia mashu, you have a tool. If you use the advice of God, you really will go to the world to come. Be'ezat Hashem. Al ken timtza ma'amrei chachamin, u'zichrono livracha, rabim kulam b'signon echad. He said that even our sages realized every time they wrote something and said something and taught something, they really did it in essence. Why? As a preparation. Everything we learn from our sages is preparation. What should we do? How do we behave? How the mitzvot arc should be done? What can we use this tool that's called life? You know, there is a thing in life called sha'on. You heard of the watch, right? Sha'on, right? A watch is, if you rearrange the letter, is onesh. You are bound by time. It's actually a punishment. Your time is limited. The time that we're on this earth, we never know. It's one of those things nobody can predict. Nobody knows how long they're going to live, what kind of time frame. The Zohar HaKadosh says, look at your time as a very limited. It says, Ki yamuta adam be'ol, a person can die any moment. They say, when you should do tshuva, you don't know where you're going, so every day should be a tshuva. Don't wait. The Gemara says, whoever says, Echtav ve'ashuv, Echtav ve'ashuv, en mesapkin be'ado. If a person says, you know what, I'll make tshuva later.
It says in Pirkei Avot, don't do that because you don't know if you're going to have time.
That's right. It's exactly in Pirkei Avot. It says, don't do that. You don't know if you have the time. Maybe the time will not be there for you. Maybe your sha'on will stop, right? Your time will stop. You know, they say that each person, the Zohar HaKadosh says, Kol ben adam lolad im kamut mesuyemet shel milim. Every person has a certain amount of words that's allowed for his life as a quota.
Breaths. That's what it's
words called. To
yes,
speak.
Breaths. You have counted your breaths.
They say, how you can extend that? By doing more words of Torah. Right? But you cannot reduce it, meaning that only if you're wicked, on the other hand. So choose your words carefully. You don't know when your words will end, right? It's like diving without a timer of how much oxygen you have, right? You're very careful about every breath you take. You don't know it's going to end at 30 meters or how it's going to maybe come back. You have to be careful with your words. It says here, the Ramchal, by the way, everything the Ramchal says, he states in his opening, he says, I did not come to teach you anything new. Ramchal, you know, Kodesh Kodashim. He says, I'm not here to teach you anything. Everything that I'm about to teach you has already been said. You just need to reinforce it. So he says here that medamim ha'olam hazeh lemakom vezman hachana ve'olam haba lemakom ha'menucha ve'achilat ha'muchan kvar. He says, this world, you prepare yourself. It's nothing by preparation of what kind of rewards you'll have in the world to come. But everything will be ready for you there. There's nothing you need to do anymore, if you've done it correctly, to be in the world to come. Why? Because if you're not, then you have to come back again. The Gilgulim, as we said, right? Gilgul comes from the word Gulgolet, right? Skull. You come back, and the Arizal said, if you want to know how many times you came to this world, how many gilgulim you were here. Look at your hands that you don't write with and see how many circles you have here. You see? Okay. I have two, I think. Yeah. Two. You've been here twice. Whoever, you know, sometimes you have more gilgulim. לפעמים יש הרבה גלגולים. תסתכלו על היד פה, right? The Arizal said, כמה גלגולים, כמה צמידים יש פה. כל צמיד זה גלגול. Every circle, it's a גלגול. And the Zohar says that you have six times, six chances to come to this world and fix. Six times, and only then you'll be decided. We learn from this from Parashat Mishpatim. Right? It says, כי תקנה לך עבד עברי, שש שנים תעבוד, ובשנה השביעית תצא לחופשי חינם. You have six chances to come, and if you're successful in the seventh, you'll go to heaven. If not, חס וחלילה, clean up. You have to go הלבנה בגיהנום. The Ramchal continue, העולם הזה דומה לפרוסדור, is mentioned in Pirkei Avot. This is just the hallway to the world to come. היום לעשותם ומחר לקבל שכרם. היום אנחנו עושים, ובעזרת השם, מחר, meaning after we pass, then we get the rewards. You know, they always ask the, many people says, what's the rewards of a mitzvah? What do you get for a mitzvah? A mitzvah. Schar mitzvah. Mitzvah, that's right. And he says that the mitzvot, really, you get the rewards in the world to come. But when we get rewards in this world, it's tzedakah from Hashem. It's chasdei Hashem. Hashem doesn't really want to give, because not enough room in this world to get the mitzvot rewards. Imagine, you take one yeshiva, right? Be'ezat Hashem, you have 600 avrechim, 1,000 avrechim. They do millions and millions of mitzvot a month. How much rewards Hashem is going to give? Not enough room in this earth to receive. There's a story I heard from Rabbi in Israel, Rabbi Eyal Amrami. He says that one time, there's a gentleman that passed away and came back after 20 minutes. היה לו מוות קליני 20 דקות. A wicked, wicked, wicked person. An adam rasha meod, and everybody was shocked that when he woke up after 20 minutes, what happened here? You were dead. We already put you in a Ziploc, ready in a fridge. 20 minutes. Usually if you're over 4 or 5 minutes, your brain is gone. That's right. Your brain is gone. It is 20 minutes. Wicked guy. So they ask him, what happened? Tell us. And he said, when I saw all, like everybody described, the light and this amazing thing, and the fear and this and that. But then came to me this one angel. He says, you see this area, this beautiful area there? That's your part in the heaven. זה חלקך בגן עדן. This wicked guy says to the angel, what do you mean גן עדן? I'm a very wicked, I know I'm a rasha. All my life I never do the tefillah, no tefillin, I didn't even have a bar mitzvah. He says, why do I get this? Maybe there's a mistake, I'm not the right guy. So the angel showed him, one time he was walking in Tel Aviv, and somebody asked him to come say Amen. They needed the 10th for a minyan, just to say Amen for Kaddish. He went in to say Amen for Kaddish. By the way, Amen is both name of Hashem. Yud Heh Vav Heh and Adonut. When you say Amen, you connect the two names. Right? 26 plus 65 in Gematria. Right? 91, Amen. 91 is Yud Heh Vav Heh and Aleph Dalet Nun Yud. For him to go and say Amen, he merited this portion. And he start crying, he says, you have to let me go back to tell everybody what they get for one mitzvah. So they know not to make averot. So they return him to earth, and he said that story. So, when we say livriut, when we say kol Yisrael yesh lahem chelek le'olam haba, every Jew has a place in the world to come and share, is not instantly. It's only if you deserve it. If you don't, then you have to go, chas v'chalila, to hell, pay for your sins, be cleaned up, and then they'll put you back in your share in heaven. It's very important to understand. And the Gemara says, there is things that you don't get part of, chas v'chalila, heaven. That's why it says, ezehu asameach b'chelko, who is happy, a person that is happy with this share of the world to come. In a chelek shelo. So continue, the Ramchal says, that it says, מי שתרח בערב שבת, יאכל בשבת. You know, in Masechet Eruvin, in the Gemara it says, whoever works for Shabbat will eat on Shabbat. You cannot come to Shabbat and not prepare anything. There will be nothing ready for you. מי שתורח בשבת, באמצע השבוע, בערב שבת, יאכל בשבת. This is our life. Whoever make avodah to prepare for the, what Shabbat? Shabbat is really Gan Eden. Every day is Shabbat in Gan Eden. There's no weekdays. All the time is Shabbat. Can you work on Shabbat? No, what do you do on Shabbat? You neena meziva shechina, you relax, you eat a good chulent, shechina, chamin, you have a good, you know, fish, you have all everything that you want, all the mata'amim. This is really olam haba, all Shabbat, kulo Shabbat. You know, when we were promised the land of milk and honey, right? What does it say? Eretz Zavat, Chalav, Udvash, right? If you take those three words, Zavat, Chalav, Udvash, Sofei Tevot, the acronym of the last Erev Shabbat. Really, this is the earth that you receive in Gan Eden. This is the earth of the milk and honey. The Shefa that you receive is not in this world, because you cannot really take it with you. If shall lakachat mipo klum. It says, Ha'olam hazeh domeh leyabasha, ועולם הבא וכולי דומה לים. He said, this world is like the land and the world to come is like the oceans. Right? How big is the ocean compared to the land? It's ends for, you know, they say Hashem created the world in a very interesting way. You know, we have what we call 28% land, right? And 72% ocean, water, right? Our body, every cell has the same components. 28% matter, body, we came from the land, and 72% water, right? Koach, 28, koach, is strength. 72 is Shem Hashem, is one name, has 72 letters. When Hashem says, I came to Bnei Israel, Ba'av, I came in Ayin Bet, I came with the 72, with my name of 72 letters. Hashem has many names. The Zohar Kadosh says that there is 304,805 otiyot b'Torah, called Zeh Shem Hashem. In the Torah, the five books of Moses, so to speak, Torat Hashem, Torat Moshe, there is 304,805 letters. All this is one name of Hashem. From Bereshit, from Bet to the end, the word Israel, called Zeh Shem Hashem. All of it is the name of Hashem. It's the coded creation. So we see here, V'tereh be'emet ma shekvar lo yuchal shum ba'al sechel la'amin. So nobody, no matter how wise you are, you will never believe the part of this creation of mankind, even though we can try to understand and assume and learn, our sages can explain. The essence of the creation, of why the person was brought in and his condition, and how he can fix it in this world, in order, ki mahem chaye adam ba'olam hazeh, what is, you need to know, what is the really the so-called life. Many people say, what's the purpose of life? And only stupid people ask this. Purpose of life is to get close to Hashem and not come here anymore. Who wants to be here? Who wants to work all day? You know, chas v'chalila, lose somebody, be sick. Who wants to, you know, have difficult times? Who wants to have sicknesses? Who wants? Mi rotzeh? Everybody said, let me be alive somewhere else without any sickness. I don't need to work. Everything is provided. Olam haba. Ki ma hem chaya adam ba'olam hazeh? What are the essence of a person in this world? Or would you be happy and peaceful with what you have in this world? Is this is something you want to maintain, to be here all the time? Right? We, the moment we are born, we start to die. Right? ברגע שנולדים, מתחילים למות. You know, something very interesting happened to our body. Right? We born as a baby and we die as a baby. נולדים כמו תינוק ומתים כמו תינוק. Right? It's very like you need help in the beginning and you need help at the end.
Hence why Chevra Kadisha is so...
It's amazing. Chevra Kadisha is the one of the holiest people exist. But they say, what Shlomo HaMelech says, he says, remember Hashem b'tziorotecha. Remember Hashem when you're good and young and strong and everything's rosy and everything's... He says, don't wait until you need Hashem when you... Everybody needs Hashem when they're old and when they're babies. Hashem says, I brought you in order to really work on yourself here. As we says, Yemei Shenoteihem Bahem 70 Shana, average of a person is 70 years. Right? That's the average. Ve'im begevurot 80 shana, but with strength and gevurot that you were a gever, gomel chasadim, the word gever is not a man, so to speak. It's actually a description of a Jew. His gimel is gomel chasadim, bet by shanim, resh rachmanim. You have to be gomel chasadim, you have to do chesed, you have to be modest, and you have to have mercy. And he says, if you like that, you'll merit 80 years. That's gvurot. Of course, tzaddikim will go on to have 90, 100, all kind. And he says here, bekama mine tzar v'chalaim v'machovim v'tradot, how many problems we have in our lives. We worry about your kids, you worry about your children, I mean your husband, your wife, you worry about your neighbors, you worry about, hey, there's so many worries and so many sicknesses. There is actually, the Gemara says in Masechet Shabbat, if I'm not mistaken, Kuf Bet, he said that there is 903 sicknesses in this world. Chas v'chalila, can you imagine this? Can you imagine having not even 10%? Chas v'chalila. It says the Ramchal here, ve'achar kol zot, what do you get? Death. Right? You work so hard all your life, then you die. You would think, you work so hard, you get rewarded. In this world, there's no rewards. The rewards we have is really the essence of the Torah. Hashem, Rabbi Yochanan, said, HaKadosh Baruch Hu zikai et Yisrael. How Hashem gave the merit to the people of Israel? He gave them Torah and mitzvot. How Hashem wants you to succeed, to be zakai, you know, to come out what we call zakai in the court in order to be innocent and to be free and not to be chas v'chalila blamed for something. Hashem gave us the Torah and mitzvot. Because of those, we'll merit Olam Haba. They said Jews could be either the best or the worst, right? We have, Baruch Hashem, too many good, righteous people that show us the light, but unfortunately we also have too many crooks and bad Jews. You know, when a Jew does something bad, the whole world describes, you have Madoff, right?
Harvey Weinstein, Jeffrey Epstein.
We don't want to mention all these bad people. Why? Because they had no Torah in their life. They were the best at what they did, but the worst of mankind. The Gemara says, "Ratza Kadosh Baruch Hu lezakot et Israel, lefichach irba lahem Torah u'mitzvot." If it wasn't for the Torah and mitzvot, all Israel would be the worst. Because of the Torah and mitzvot, really Hashem saved the world. You know, some of the worst thing created in the world was by Jews. If you take communism, Who started this?
Karl Marx.
Karl Marx and seven of his Jewish buddies in Russia. Who did the first atomic bomb?
Well, it wasn't just Einstein.
Yeah. Jews created many of the worst things. They created many of good things. Baruch Hashem. But in reality, people that didn't have God took their powers to the left, to the klipa. The Ramchal says, Chaz v'chalila, אחד מיני אלף לא ימצא שירבה העולם לא הנאות ושלווה אמיתית. If you ask one out of 1,000 people, are you really 100% happy? Are you really 100% peaceful? Maybe one of 1,000. Maybe. Everybody has problems. Don't ever look at somebody else and think, oh, I wish I had that, because you don't know their problem. You don't know what they have. Nobody knows. Everything is chadre chadarim in the heart, right? There's four bedroom Airbnb that we rent from Hashem, right? The heart, the pump that gives us life, so to speak, right? The blood is the nefesh. The blood goes through the heart, supply the whole body with oxygen. But in reality, Hashem, whatever you have is what you need. What you want is not what you need. Remember that. What you have is exactly what Hashem wants you to have. What you don't have is because Hashem, you don't really need it. Many people ask for things and they don't understand why they don't get it, because it's bad for them. It's very important. The Ramchal says, remember, v'gam hu, even a person that come to 100 years, it's like somebody cannot do. It's like somebody avaru v'tel min ha'olam. It's somebody that, there's nothing, 100, you can barely move. You're just really breathing until you pass. You know, I always say, let's say an average of 70 years, a lifetime. You know, 70 shana, memutza. Half of this you're asleep. Nakhon? Most people sleep half of their life. Most people sleep half. If you take teenager, they sleep 2/3. I have two of them, I know. But in reality, what happened? Let's say you sleep even 40%, not half, okay? So you have 40 years left. From these 40 years, you're not obligated by a punishment from the heavens by 20, from the earth by 13. So you really have 20 years. In these 20 years, what do? You go to the bathroom at least 2 years. You work, when I say bathroom, eating in the bathroom, you know? You spend enough time between the kitchen and the bathroom all your life, about 2 years. You go to work half of the time, even third, let's say third of the time, right? Then you're busy with all the mundane thing, another 2 years, 3 years. At the end, you have maybe 10 years to really be righteous. Maybe. Really, your life, ketzel over, right? David HaMelech says like a shadow that passes you. When you go by a light, it goes to one side to the other, boom.
When you compare it to eternal time, yes.
Yes, but
you can be righteous the whole time. So with the experience,
that's the key, is to take every advantage of every moment in your life to be righteous. That's really exactly what you said. That's the essence. In order to be close to what the rewards is really you're deserving of. Or chas v'chalila, the punishment of the other ways. ולא, the Ramchal continues, says, אלא שאם תכלית בריאת האדם היה לצורך העולם הזה, לא היה צריך מפני שזה שתנופח בו נשמע כל כך חשובה ועליונה. The Ramchal says, if a person, what's the essence of a person? How do we become a living thing? It says in the Torah, ויפח נשמתו, ויהי אדם לנפש חיה. Hashem took from his own breath and blew into Adam, and the Adam became alive. Before it was just a dirt. Right? We'll take a second here. That's the beauty of the outdoor kollel. It says, so why would Hashem take something from him and put in you, if not for you to be like him? right? The Ramchal says, this, by putting the neshama within you, כל כך חשובה ועליונה שתהיה גדולה יותר מכל המלאכים. A person can be better than the angels. You know, angels have one task. That's it, one task. Every angel has one task. רק הקדוש ברוך הוא שולח אותם לשליחות אחת. Right? People have many, many, many שליחויות. Many opportunities. Hashem sends you to do many things. That's why it says, בצלם אלוהים ברא אותם. He created the image of God, so you'll be capable and able to do as many things just as God. Except, you know, things that you cannot do like God.
Except you can't do
it
without God.
That's right. You have to have
you
God.
Can try, but
it's not going to be successful. But Hashem says, if you want to be tzaddik, I'll make you the best tzaddik. If you want to be a crook, I'll make you the best crook. בדרך שרוצה ללכת מוליכים אותו. It says, in the way you want to work, I will help you, whether for good or bad. Because you have the ability of God and goodness, but you also have the ability, chas v'chalila, if you stray from me, the other power will take over you. Chas v'shalom. So he says, what's gedola yoter min ha-malachim? It's bigger than the angels. כל שכן שאינה מוציאה שום נחת רוח בכל עינוגי זה העולם. He says, your neshama is really doesn't enjoy anything from this world. The physical stuff. Only the mitzvot. The neshama is Hashem Natan. Really, the neshama is neshima, right? To breathe. The neshama is Mishnah, to learn Mishnayot, right? The neshama is shmone, eight. It's above nature, always on, never stops. The Ramchal says, really, all this, what this neshama was brought here to help you get to the better place, because nothing, she wants nothing to do here in this world. Remember, the neshama does not like the body. She always wants to get out, every night even. The neshama ozevet et guf ha'adam kol laila, every night goes out. Why? To do two things. To get connected back to the source. It's like a charger, right? If you have a phone, if you're not charged, it's just a paperweight, right? You have to recharge every night. Send the neshama. And she records everything that happened that day. Hence YouTube, it's already existing. The clouds of glory, as we mentioned, and everything. Vehu, the Ramchal continues, says, Vehu ma shelimdanu zichrono livracha b'midrash Kohelet. He says, that's what Shlomo HaMelech taught us in the book of Kohelet. And what did it say? And it's also mentioned in Midrash Kohelet Rabbah. It says, "Vegam hanefesh lo timale." You can never ever fulfill your nefesh. As we know, there's five parts to our neshama. Right? We have nefesh, ruach, neshama, chaya, ve'yechida. He said that even the nefesh does not get full. It can never fulfill the nefesh. It says, King Solomon, he gave us a parable in Kohelet. Mashal lema hadavar dome. He says that, what is this like? He says, le'ironi shenasa bat melech. If you take a princess, and they do a shidduch with a very simpleton kind of guy, somebody who is not very wise, not very versed in the world, in kingship, just one of the crowd, so to speak. He can bring her anything he wants. She doesn't really, she says, my father is the king. He owns the whole world. What can you bring me? I have, you want to bring me a yacht? I have 10 yachts. You want to bring me gold? I have 100 and tons of gold. You want to bring me diamonds? Here, let me show you, millions of diamonds. There's nothing he can satisfy a princess of a king because she has it all. It's the Dakar Neshama. A Neshama does not want all these mundane things in this world. She's Bat Melech, is the daughter of a king. Kacha Nefesh, our Nefesh is like that. Ilu evet ala kol ma'adane olam, even if you brought all the good stuff a person can desire to eat, the Nefesh does not need that. Even if you bring all the gifts in the world, klum, it says, Shehi min ha'elyonim, our Nefesh, our Neshama, it's from the upper world. There is no mundane there. It's only goodness and spiritual. וכן אמרו רבותינו זכרונם לברכה, and our sages say, as we mentioned in פרקי אבות before, על כורחך אתה נוצר ועל כורחך אתה נולד. Whether you like it or not, you were born. And as we know, the biggest machloket, the longest, not the biggest, the longest machloket, a discussion was between Shammai and Bet Hillel, Bet Shammai and Bet Hillel, for 2.5 years, whether it was worth it for a person to be born or not. 2.5 years they're debating. האם טוב לאדם שנולד או לא? After all said and done, they decided that it was better for the person not to be born. But they say, if you were born, פשפש במעשיו. You have to look into you, what have you done before, and fix it this life. Question is, how do you know what you've done before? What needs to be fixed?
What you can do is freeze frame your moment right now, you can see everything you've ever done before.
Yaakov is a good idea, but they say, whatever is the hardest for you to do, that's what you came to fix. Right, Yaakov? What's the hardest thing for you? Don't tell me. That's what you came to fix.
I believe, how do I know, but I think I got a clue.
We all know, everybody knows. When you stand in front of the mirror, who are you looking at?
That's a question I'm gonna ask you in the beginning.
Mirror, mirror on the wall. You're looking at yourself. You know what needs to be fixed. Nobody needs to tell you. Hashem, with his mighty and amazing creation, gave us something. It's called conscience. You heard of it? Matzpun. You know what you've done. You know how far can you go and how far you need to come back. You know what needs to fix. You know what you can improve on. We all know. En apotropus la'arayot, right? There is no, even for the toughest lion and the toughest rabbis, there is no protection. They have to protect themselves.
Yes, there's no hiding from God. You can
there's
pretend,
no hiding.
You think.
He says, what happened? A person is really was born because even if they didn't want and they came to this world, they came be'al korcham, not because they want to. The neshama did not want to come to this world. They said that women come to this world to help men. The Zohar says, it's amazing. He says, most righteous women never had to come here. They just come here to fix their husband, their other half. Because you know, before you marry, you're half, right? Only after you marry, you're full. That's why it's called soulmate, right? The Gemara says, a person that's not married is a half a person. And when you marry, you're full. Why? Adam and Eve were created with one neshama, half and half. Only after Hashem brought him back the real Chava, he said, "Apam ikara bezo isha." This is the real woman, because you made her out of my other half, from me. The first one was not so good. It says here, "Ki en haneshama ohevet haolam hazeh klal." The neshama hates this world. Ela adraba, mu'eset bo.
Only by comparison.
No. Every neshama, listen. If you knew your neshama.
Right. To break from the source is a suffering.
Yeah, but your neshama doesn't really want to be here. There is a guy in Israel, always was fighting with his wife. And he always called her neshama, neshama. You know, in Hebrew, neshama is like, oh, it's a motek, my dear. My dear, like as a term of endearment. Eze neshama, eze. Kol hazman ravim, hu kore lishto, eze neshama, eze. Az amru lo, החברים שלו, מה זה איזה נשמה? אתה כל הזמן, אתה שונא אותה, אתה רב איתה כל הזמן. מה אתה קורא לנשמה? אז הוא אומר, יבוא מלאך המוות, אני בא לקחת את הנשמה. אני אומר לו, הנה, בבקשה, קח אותה. So it says, this husband was fighting with his wife all the time. But he used to call her my neshama, my neshama, neshama. His friend says, what are you, crazy? You hate your wife. We see you. You fight with her for years now. He says, yeah, one day Satan will come, the angel of death. He says, I'm here to take your neshama. I'll say, here she is. Take her. It's a joke.
A long way around.
It's a very funny joke. But let's continue. אם כן, ודאי לא היה בורא העולם, הבורא יתברך בריאה לתכלית שהיא או הוא כנגד חוקה ונמאס ממנה. So we have to understand, Hashem did not create this neshama without a תכלית. You know, in Hebrew we have a word תכלס. תכלס is really, is Ashkenaz for תכלית. Right? תכלית is the essence. If you read that the word תכלית, it's a very interesting word. You have tough in the beginning and tough at the end, right? There is Torah before you came to this world and be Torah after you leave this world. In the center, you have Kli, your vessel. Your body is a vessel for this neshama, to make it a part of the tachlit, of the real essence of why this neshama came to this world. HaKadosh Baruch Hu brought her here. There's no mistake, there's no miscalculation. It's not chas v'chalila something that it's wrong. You have to find this essence of this neshama, what this neshama needs you to fix. All the neshamot of the Jewish people came from Adam. One neshama came to the world. All the Jewish people around the world, it's come from this neshama, sparks of Adam HaRishon. All the goyim came from Lamed Yud, Lamed Yud Tav, Satan and his wife. That's why you can be in a room with a goy that died. It doesn't have tumah. A goy that dies is not impure. You can still be in a still, let's say,
that's
Jews.
No,
it's exactly the opposite. Jews, if you are in a room that a person died, you're tameh. You have to go to the mikveh at night. You have to do all this stuff. But when a goy, let's say a goy died with you in the car, you're not tameh. They don't have the kedusha of Adam HaRishon, of Hashem. They are part of creation, the children of God, but they're not the Jewish neshama. The Gemara speaks a lot about it in the Shulchan Aruch. He says here, Ella b'riyato shel Adam lematzav ba'olam haba. He, as we mentioned, the essence of the creation of this neshama is to bring this person in this world to olam haba. ארוך אתה אדוני מחולם שהכל נעבור. So, tell them I'm not here, huh? ועל כן ניתנה בו נשמה זאת. That's why Hashem put this נשמה. כי לה ראוי לעבוד. This נשמה is came to help this person. To do the work, ובה יוכל האדם לקבל השכר. This is how this person will merit to receive the rewards in that time, in this world, like for us to have a place like this, or to have a home, to be able to see, this is the reward in this world. So we see that HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, I'm sending you this neshama to help you. And he says, ושלא יהיה דבר נמאס. I said, don't do anything bad that's for this neshama. Right? As we mentioned before, our neshama is like a brand new car you lease. So listen, I'm giving you a brand new car. Use it for a certain amount of time. Bring it back to me. A little scratch here and there is fine. But don't destroy it. You have to pay for the whole car. HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, don't do anything that the neshama will hate. By the way, sachar is rewards. It's the word kasher. When you eat kosher, you get sachar. Everything has its mitzvah, midah for neged midah, midah keneged midah, measure for measure. It says, Ela adraba, ne'a ve'nechmad mimena ve'ze pashut. So the opposite, really, you should give your neshama such this that she would be in love with you. So neshama want to be with you. When a neshama leave a person because she cannot take it anymore. When a person die young, chaz v'chalila, or die a horrific, the neshama was so unhappy. When a person does mitzvah, the neshama lives quietly. They say, the Zohar Kadosh, Yaakov, please.
Sorry.
The Zohar Kadosh, don't worry, you will not get sachar for living Torah. The Zohar Kadosh says that a tzaddikim know 30 days before they pass. Birds in the sky announce they're coming to heaven. Tzaddikim. Rasha'im, you never know. And Chaz v'chalila, he says sometimes the death is so horrific because the more you hurt this neshama, the worse it takes. It's hard to take out the neshama. The pain is a little bit more excruciation. This is a horrific pain. He says, v'ze pashut. This is really the simple thing. V'hine, achar she'yadanu ze, and when you realize this, the Ramchal said, navin, miyad chomer ha-mitzvot. What's the, really, the mitzvah is what's called the chumriyut, right? The mitzvah is something you have to gather the physical with the spiritual. In order to do a mitzvah, there's a chomer to it. Chomer is meruach. It's come from a spiritual place. Everything that we have here, it's come from a ruchniyut, from above. Asher alenu v'yakar ha'avodah asher b'yadenu. It's given to us, and it's a very expensive things in our hand. It's like Hashem give us this collateral in our hand. Ki hine ele hem ha'emtzayim ha'meviim otanu el ha'shlemut ha'amiti. Those are, how do you really come to shlemut, to be whole? Is through the mitzvot. As we said, Talmud Torah keneged kulam. When you learn Torah, you'll know everything, and that's how you do the mitzvot correctly. And he says, "Asher bil'adam lo yusak klal." Without this mitzvot, he can never reach anything. A person cannot say, "I'm going to just learn Torah without doing mitzvot." It's nothing. It's a waste of time. Asiyat ha-mitzvot, to do the mitzvot, is really mekayem ha-Torah. When Hashem gave us the mitzvot in the Torah, He didn't say just learn about them. Do it. Va'asitem otam. You have to do it. When you do something, the word mitzvah is tzavta, is gathering. You gather yourself with the neshama and Hashem. You give all the elements of the physical and spiritual way. It says, ve'ulam yadua ki en ha'tachlit magia ella mikoach ha'kibbutz. So we mentioned the tachlit, the essence of this, is the gathering of all the elements. Kol ha'emtzayim, Hashem nimtze'u ve'asher shimshu la'agio. Hashem gave you all that you need to use in order to get and to get to this level. Ve'kfi koach ha'emtzayim ve'shimusham, according to this powerful use of media and medium that HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave you, according to how you do it, it's what the sachar, the essence you will receive. If you, let's say you do a mitzvah, but without love, you do it without any really simcha, it doesn't count. You did a mitzvah, but it's a mitzvah at the level of zero. You want to do a mitzvah at the level of 10. When somebody comes to you and says, you know, help me, I'm hungry, give me. Say, come on, please, be happy to do Hashem. The Zohar HaKadosh says, when a person, stranger, come to you and ask for tzedakah, this person was your part of your life in the last life that she is giving you a chance to fix the tzedakah. Yaakov, you only get parnasa from Torah. Okay, not
somebody,
Torah from parnasa.
Baruch
Hashem, they're leaving, they'll be fine. Baruch Hashem, Atzlacha, Nesia Tova. That's right. Yeshar Koach. So we say here that HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, according to how you do it, that's your reward. How do you get the mitzvah? The real tachlit is how you do the mitzvah. Like I said before, we mentioned, if do it Hashem besimcha, love and do Hashem with happiness, not with sorrow, not with pain. Hashem doesn't want this. You need to do it with simcha. במחשבה, בחמישה חושים. He says, באמצעים אלה תיבחן תולדתו בבירור, ודאי, בהגיע הזמן התכלית, הנולד מקיבוץ כולם. By the essence of your gathering, you'll see what the mitzvah, really the reward, and it's written, and it's understood. Because you know, when HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave the mitzvot, He showed Moshe Rabbeinu how to do it. Moshe Rabbeinu, many mitzvot he had no idea how to do. When Moshe spent 120 days in Mount Sinai, it was really to understand everything. When the Pirkei Avot says, Moshe kibel Torah miSinai, umasara liYoshua, viYoshua laskinim. He says that Moshe, in order to have the Kabbalah, to receiving the Torah and to understand the mitzvot and the Musar and the Halachot, he had to be as humble as Mount Sinai. Technically, he did not receive the Torah from the mountain. He received the Torah from Hashem in the mountain, at the mountain. But the mountain, as we mentioned, it was such a humility among all the mountains. It was the smallest of mountains. And because of the humility, Hashem says, give it to the Mount Sinai. The word Sinai is what we call Nisi, it's my miracle. Moshe understood the whole Torah. He reached the 50 gates of wisdom, Nun Bo. How? Hashem showed him everything. It says in the Torah, Asher Arati Lecha, like I showed you, B'mar'eh. I showed you pictures, videos, schematics, I've shown you everything. So you see, because you know when you see, when you understand, you know how to do a mitzvah. Right? They said that tachlit mitzvah is to do it with happiness. Can you turn that off? Turn it off.
Okay, you can be serious, but I can't.
So, we said, מעתה ודאי הוא שדקדוק שידקדק על עניין המצוות והעבודה. You have to be very careful, meticulous, with exactly how the mitzvah is prepared and how to do it correctly. And what's this work, avoda? When the Torah says avoda, it means the korbanot. Today we don't have sacrifice, no korbanot. So hu neshalma parim sfatenu, we can learn about it. How do we do it? Why do we do it? What's the essence? There's lots and lots of masachtot in the Gemara about korbanot and books about to explain what's the essence of sprinkling the blood and why this korban has to be kosher and why this korban and not this korban. Why this, I cannot have a korban that doesn't have Shabbat in it at least 8 days or 1 year. There's all kinds of things. By learning the mitzvot, you really do the mitzvah correctly. And he says, מוכרח שיהיו בתכלית הדקדוק כאשר דקדקו שוקלי זהב. You have to take the understanding as if you weigh gold. If you sell an ounce of gold, would you ever give an ounce and a half for the price of an ounce? You'll be very careful, right? Or when you buy, would you take 90% of the ounce or you want 100% of it because you pay for 100%? That's how you should weigh the mitzvot. And don't forget, David HaMelech says, קלה כבחמורה. Never think that the easy mitzvah is the best, the easiest, and there's a mitzvah, a big mitzvah is the bigger. No. All mitzvot are equal. You don't know which one will be better for you in the world, in the long run, in the world to come. How you did it in the essence, you were meticulous about it. And he says, you weigh it like you weigh gold and pninim larov, yekaram. You know pnina, you know what's a pnina in Hebrew? A pearl. You know, I don't know if you know how a pearl is made.
Piece of sand.
That's right. Yesh atzot, you have, you know, a clam that a little tiny piece of sand, one grain of sand, goes inside, because you know the clams open and close. It goes one piece of sand that irritate the skin inside, and the clam has this, what we have in our body, this vitamin K, like the mugla, you know, the yellow vitamin from the white blood cells that attack the cut to stop the bleeding and to heal the, if anything that, you know, mosquito bites you or whatever, there is this amazing, unbelievable, billions of doctors rushing to the place where you were bitten or cut to heal the place. This clamp has the same mechanism to stop this grain of sand and cover it so it doesn't hurt anymore. And from that come the pearl that could cost hundreds of thousands sometimes, right? From a grain of sand and a healing process, you have something that costs thousands of dollars. Ma rabu ma'asech Hashem. He says, that's how you need to be careful. You think it's a grain of sand, but at the end it could be such reward. Like the pearl. It says here, כי תולדתם נולדת בשלמות, He said the toladot of the mitzvot, you know, we have what we call toladot, avot melacha. There's all kinds of level of the mitzvot. And they were born into this world, like, you know, to give birth, noledet, beshlemut, they come complete. In the essence of the real and the most expensive and the endless, hanitzchi she'en yakar le'mama le'meno. It comes, the mitzvah comes in such ways that it's powerful to all the things that you can think of, from its truthness, the emet, from its essence, from its how expensive it is, hayakar, hanitzchi, how infinite it is, that there is nothing more important than that, even in the heavens. A power of mitzvah. נמצאים למדים, so we learn from this, the Ramchal says, כי עיקר מציאות האדם בעולם הזה, the essence of person of this world, לקיים מצוות, is to make mitzvot and to stand the challenges that Hashem bring upon him. You know, we have a lot of challenges. We have a lot of chas v'chalila, Hashem, tackle us, yetzer hara, all the time. Right? During the day, you're constantly fighting among yourself. Right? Sometimes, I always say, if you want to hear the loudest argument, just be quiet. It's in your head. Do this, don't do this. Yes, do that. No. You go back and forth. It's, who is this? It's just me by myself. What is all this noise? He said, really, HaKadosh Baruch Hu put those experiments in you to see how you're going to handle. When HaKadosh Baruch Hu give you anything that you think is bad, it's not really bad. Hashem wants to see what you do with it. Hashem will never ever give you anything he cannot handle. Ever. You will be able to withstand anything. Hashem will never give you something you cannot handle. Never, ever, ever. Guaranteed. Hashem give you this to see what you're going to do with it. You know the word ba'aya. You know what's ba'aya in Hebrew? Ba'aya means problem, right?
Like balagan.
Ba'aya, like balagan. Close. Ba'aya is really an acronym. Be'ezratia. Be'ezrat Hashem, you'll solve it. Any problem can be solved by Ezrat Hashem. How? Use the mitzvot, use the Torah. Hashem says, divkubi, have to be like a glue to me. When you glue to something, you're always with it. When you take the glue off, most likely you'll be away from it. Hashem says, mitzvah la'amod ve'la'amod banisayon. Hashem says, you have to, it's a mitzvah, to even withstand the test. The essence, even though it's not, it doesn't tell you mitzvah how to do things as far as the experience, right? What you do with it and how you really work hard on it is a big mitzvah. V'anaot ha'olam, he said there's many pleasure to this world, right? Hashem gives so many pleasures. Why? To try us, to see, are we going after this mundane pleasure of our body or are we going after the pleasure of our neshama? Of the mitzvot. En ra'u shiyu lo ella le'ezer. Those pleasure that Hashem give you should come to help you, not to destroy you. Remember, you can do anything, almost anything that the goy can do. Just do it in Kedusha. Everything is, Hashem says, I'm giving you everything in this world for who? For you to enjoy. I don't need this. I need you to utilize this good that I give you for goodness. שיהיה לו נחת רוח וישוב ודעת למען יוכל לפנות ליבו אל העבודה. He says that when you train yourself to control these experiments and all the pleasure in the world, then you have נחת רוח. Then you're like, ah. You know, they say a peace of mind is $1 million and more, right? There's many rich people that have billions and hundreds of millions or whatever. They never have peace of mind. Yet you have a person that have a $500, he feels like he's rich as Korach. Why? Because he has nachat ruach. His mind, the ruach, the spiritual, is already such in a place that it's all nachat. You know, husband and wife, they call chatan and kala, right? Chatan is nachat. He has to bring beautiful nachat to his wife. And kala is hakol. The kala should be everything to her husband. They should be the perfect couple only through Torah and mitzvot. And he says here, this is the essence, zot ha'avodah ha'mutelet alav. That's what Hashem gave you to this world. He gave you this task, so to speak. Ve'omnam, ra'u lo she'tiyeh kol pniyato rak le'borei itbarach. He says that everything you do, you should have Hashem in mind. Even when you have, let's say, sickness.
I'm sorry, but someone's here for me.
Is atzlacha. Atzlacha be'ezrat Hashem. So, everything that Hashem gave you is really, if you have problem, come to Hashem, ask Him. Pniyato rak la'borei itbarach. You know, when you ask a person to, you know, please, you know, help me this and that, and you don't ask Hashem first, as if you put your trust in mankind. Al tiftechu ba'adam ki en lo teshua. Hashem says, I challenge you because I want you to come back to me. Hashem give you something, lekarev, to get you closer. Veshelo yeh shum tachlit acher bechol ma'aseh she'aseh. Why? He says, chas v'chalila, you have to not do anything that doesn't have the essence. And everything you do, whether it's small or big, only leitkarev elav. You have to get close to HaKadosh Baruch Hu and to break those barriers between you and Him. Mechitzot shemafsikot beino leven kono. HaKadosh Baruch Hu made us. Like you want your children to be far from you, you want them to be close to you. When the children need help, you want them to go to a stranger or come to you. That's as Hashem says. I'm here with you all the time. Male kol haaretz kevodo. I'm here everywhere. Just talk to me. If you need help, I'll send you help. Don't worry. But I'm here first. They say whoever asks a doctor to heal before Hashem, chas v'chalila, not guaranteed refuah shelema. Hen hena kol inyane achomriyut. This is in essence everything is come from the mundane things, the chomer, the thing that's come to this world. Vetalui bahem ad shiyimashech acharav itbarach mamash kebarzel achar even ashoevet. So it says that, you know, if you put, let's say for an example, a heavy weight of metal, right, into water, it goes back so fast, right? It goes down so fast. Or you put a stone in the ocean, right? The drops are heavy. This is how you need to go after Hashem, in this kind of speed and connectivity, because it's really the koach ha-meshicha, you know, what we call meshicha, the gravity. It really should be to Hashem, because our world stands on gravity that you cannot explain. We should all be floating in space, right? The ocean should be spills into space. Nothing. This is koach ha-meshicha. This is v'shachanti betocham. Hashem reside within us. V'chol ma sheyuchal lachshov shehu emtza'i lekorva hazot yirdof acharav. He says, whenever you see something that is this medium that can connect you to that, run after it. Don't walk. Run. And hold on to it and never let go. When people hold on to a good mitzvah, to study Torah, to setting time for Torah, never leave it. The moment you leave it, you'll be busy with fixing your car. Chaz v'chalila, you'll be busy with doing other things. V'kol ma sheyuchal lachshov, shehu meni'a lezeh. Do everything to avoid, chaz v'chalila, the opposite of not chasing that goodness. Yivrach mimeno, if you chaz v'chalila have the opposite, that means you're going the wrong way. Run away like you run away from fire. Who wants to go into fire? Very few people. Avraham Avinu was one of them. When Nimrod challenged Avraham to see who is really the bigger God, Avraham made a deal with him. Avraham says, listen, whoever wins, convert to the other. Okay? Meaning that, you know, Avraham Avinu says to him, I'll go to the fire, but if I come out, you will announce that there is Hashem and denounce your God, your Avodah Zarah. Promise, they made a deal. Of course, Nimrod was the father of all Tumah in the world. And he built such a Kivshan, he built such fire that Burning Man was nothing compared to that. It was a fire that they say, just the heat that came from out of it, people burn on the outside. And they had to shoot Avraham into it. And as we know, Avraham Avinu went into it and came out not even a little smidge of fire. Hashem saved him. He says, "Echad ba'olamo, ve'echad ani ba'olami." He says, "There's one like him in my world, and I'm the only one in this world. I will save him personally." The angel wanted to say. So Avraham said to, by the way, he was only Avram without the hey yet. Avram, he was a father of many nations. He says to Nimrod, "Okay, I want you now convert, be a Hebrew." He said, no, I'll tell you what, I'm going to give you my son instead. Eliezer was the son of Nimrod, Avraham's servant. And as we know, he was a righteous man of the world. He's one of the 10 that went to heaven. He didn't have to convert, but he did what Avraham always told him. And he was so close to Hashem that he merited to go up to the heavens alive. So we see Avraham Avinu, even Hashem put him in the fire. He had such faith in Hashem, he did not worry. He says, "Davka nafshi acharecha." You know, in the book of Tehillim, David HaMelech says, "My soul is glued upon you, to be always behind you, always next to you." Bitam chayeminecha. Because I do that, your right arm support me. You know, there's right, which is right, and there's left, which is wrong. Right? That's why the Torah, the Ten Commandments, has the right side is all good, the left side, Elohim Yishmor. So we see here, and we'll finish with that. Kevan shebiyato la'olam eina ella letachlit hazeh, as the essence of a person that come to this world is for that, to be close to Hashem and to prepare his neshama to go back to heaven. Dehainu la'asig et hakirva hazot b'malto nafsho mikol monei ha'mafsideha, to remove yourself from all the sins and all the avonot and all the pesha, everything that could make you go the other way of Hashem, avoid it. This is your essence. So Be'ezat Hashem, I want to thank all of you for watching us online and being here in the Kollel. Baruch Hashem, this is Kollel Ahavat Israel. I'm Rabbi Dahan in La Jolla. Toda Rabba, please share this with everybody, and we'll post this class on our website at neshatorah.org. Hatzlacha. Bye.